Welcome to this video on versioning in SharePoint 2013. Here, we'll take an in-depth look at settings that affect the tracking and approval of content. This video will cover document version history, content approval, and checkout/check-in. Versioning is used far more often in libraries than lists, so our examples focus on files and libraries, but we'll note any differences that apply to items and lists. Document version history lets you track the changes to files over time. This can be very useful because it is the history of who made what changes, as well as a method to restore earlier information. Let's use this document library to see how to configure document version history. Click the Library tab, Library Settings, and Versioning Settings. In Document Version History, choose Create Major Versions. NCDOT suggests using major versions, but not major and minor versions. Let's opt to keep three major versions. NCDOT recommends keeping no more than 3 to 5 versions of a file for two reasons. First, each version consumes disk space, so excessive versioning may tax system resources. Second, NCDOT performs regular backups, so files can be retrieved that way as well. Click OK to complete the configuration. Let's go to another library to see how versioning works. This particular library has major versioning enabled with a limit of 3. I've edited this file several times, and each time I noted the version number in the header to help with this demo. Look at the file's history by clicking the ellipsis by the file name, the ellipsis in the callout, and version history. There are 3 previous versions, as well as current version 5.0. Version 1.0 is no longer available because it exceeded the number of major versions to keep. Open the earliest version of the file, which is 2.0, and click OK to trust the document. When version 2.0 opens in Word, you see options to compare and restore. Click Compare to see the differences between version 2.0 and the current version, which is 5.0. 2 additional documents open: the document for the current version, as well as a new document that compares versions 2.0 and 5.0. Let's look at the comparison document. On the far right, you see both versions. In the middle is a comparison that shows the differences in the headers. And on the left is the type of change and the author. Close the comparison document without saving changes. The document for the current version 5.0 is behind version 2.0, so let's click it to move it to the front. Confirm that it's version 5.0 and close it as well. We now see the version 2.0 document again. Note that the title says Backup Version, Read Only. Let's use Restore to make version 2.0 the current version. When the document refreshes, the title no longer says Backup or Read Only. And if we scroll right, the document header indicates version 2. Close the document. After the version history refreshes, the 3 previous versions are now 3.0 to 5.0, with the current version of 6.0. And when you open version 6.0, you'll see that it is the version 2.0 that was restored. Here are a few notes about using versioning in lists. Major versioning works exactly the same for lists, except that the setting is called Item Version History rather than Document Version History. NCDOT allows an unlimited number of major versions for items. If you use attachments in a list, those attachments are not versioned. Content approval controls whether a file must be reviewed and approved before it's available to library users. Let's use our original document library to see how to enable content approval. Click the Library tab, Library Settings, and Versioning Settings. In Content Approval, click Yes to enable the feature. Options under Draft Item Security become available, so you can determine who can see files that have not been approved, You can choose among any user who can read items, only users who can edit items, or only users who can approve items, and the author of the item. Generally, the last option is the one that's most suitable. Click OK. When you return to the library, you'll see that a column for approval status has been added. The new Approve Reject Items view is grouped by approval status and has a new column for approver comments. The My Submissions view is also grouped by approval status. Let's look at another library that already has content approval enabled. Several files have been uploaded to this library, and you'll see two of them have a pending status. The My Submissions view shows the files that the current user has submitted, and the Approve Reject Items view shows the files in the current user's queue for review. In this example, I happen to have the permissions to both submit and approve files, so there's no difference in these views. To review and change a file status, click the ellipsis by the file name, the ellipsis in the callout, and Approve Reject. Let's approve one of the pending files, but reject the second file with a comment about incomplete information. Those comments appear in the Approve Reject Items view. NCDOT SharePoint contributors do not necessarily have the permissions to approve files, so if you need to set up someone as an approver, call or email the help desk to request assistance from web services. Content approval and draft item security work exactly the same for lists as they do for libraries. You can require that users check out a file for editing. This means that the checked-out file is locked, and although other users can view a copy of it, they cannot edit it. Changes are visible only after the file is checked in. This option helps prevent competing changes and accidental overwrites. Let's use our original document library to see how to enable this. Click the Library tab and Library Settings. Click Versioning Settings. Scroll down to Require Checkout, click Yes to turn on the feature, and click OK. Now, let's go to a library that already has the Require Checkout setting turned on. Several files have already been uploaded into the library. The green arrow icon indicates that they have not been checked in yet, so we can check all of them in at the same time, noting that they are part of this demo. To edit a file, click its name, and you'll see the Open Document options. Choose Checkout and Edit, and click OK. I'll move the file out of the way for a moment, so when the library page is refreshed, you'll see that the file name has a green arrow to indicate it's checked out. I'll move the file back into view, and make a small edit by deleting part of the header. Save the file. When you attempt to close the file, you are reminded to check it in. Enter a comment about your change to help the next person who uses the file. If you refresh the library page, the green arrow is gone, so the file is now available to others to edit. Checkout, check-in is not available for lists. In this video, we've reviewed list and library settings for document version history, content approval, and checkout check-in. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint Help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.